In this problem, we have a block with a given mass on a level surface, and we're pulling on it with a string that has a known tension in it. I should have written units on this. That's 40 newtons. That string pulls up at an angle of 35 degrees, and we're going to approach the whole problem using work and energy here. So in part A, we're asked for the work done by the tension and the work done by the friction. In part B, we apply the work energy theorem and compute the final speed of the block after it's been dragged through a distance of 3.2 meters. So a key starting point here is to decompose that tension into its components. So our x component is given by 40 times the cosine of 35 degrees. This gives us about 32.8 newtons. Our y component, that's 40 sine 35. And this gives us 22.9 newtons. Now that vertical component is really important because that's tampering with the balance of forces in the vertical direction. That changes the normal force, which in turn changes the friction force. As a next step, let's get in the normal force vector and the weight vector. And the weight vector, or the force of gravity, of course, is mg. I know my mass, I may as well put a number on it right here in the diagram. So m is 7.5 kilograms. We usually use 9.8 for g. And this gives me 73 and a half newtons. Now again, one of the most common mistakes here is to immediately say that the normal force is equal to the same number as the weight. But in this problem, it's less than the weight, and it's because the upward component of tension is cooperating with the normal force to balance the force of gravity. So our normal force is less. And what we're doing is saying all the upward forces on this block must balance all the downward forces. So n plus the vertical component of that tension has to be equal to mg. We know the block is constrained to this horizontal surface. There's no acceleration vertically. Therefore, the forces must balance vertically. That's the argument behind this. And so I have that the normal force is mg minus the vertical component of that tension. And I plug my numbers in. That's 73 and a half newtons downward. And then my vertical component of the tension was a 22.9 newtons upward. The normal force given by the difference between them. And this gives me a normal force of 50.6 newtons. Now the reason this matters is because it allows us to compute the magnitude of the friction force. So there's the friction force, little fk. And the magnitude of the kinetic friction force is given by our friction coefficient, mu k, multiplying the normal force. We're given a kinetic friction coefficient of 0.225, and the normal force we just calculated was 50.6 newtons. This gives us a friction force of 11.4 newtons, just keeping three significant digits. And we're finally ready to compute the work done by each of the requested forces. So the work done by the tension, that's the parallel component of the force, Tx, 32.8 newtons. So the work done by the tension, 32.8 newtons, parallel component of the force, multiplying the displacement. And this parallel component is in the exact same direction as the displacement. So it's just a simple multiplication. And to three significant digits, I get 105 joules of work. Now, to get the work done by friction, there's only one minor complication. The friction force points opposite the direction of the displacement vector, which means we get a minus sign out of the work. And the magnitude of my friction force was 11.4. The displacement, again, was 3.2 meters. And I arrive at a work done by friction of negative 36.5 joules. This is the classic case of friction sucking energy out of a system. It's doing negative work, slowing things down compared to if it wasn't there. Now again, the intent with part B was to use the work energy theorem. So I want to look at the net work that was done on this block, and I have some positive and some negative. So there's 105 joules positive from pulling to the right on it with this string, 36.5 joules negative from friction slowing things down, and I get 68.5 joules of work net. Now the work energy theorem just says that the net work you do on something causes a change in its kinetic energy. So I'll write that as k final minus k initial. Well, the block started from rest. So k initial is zero. And I just have that the net work I put into this thing turns into its final kinetic energy. Of course, that final kinetic energy can be expressed as 1/2 times m times the final speed squared. And we may as well just solve this symbolically. I get that v, if I multiply both sides by 2, divide by m, and square root the result, v is 2 times the net work divided by m, all square rooted. And when we run the numbers on this to three significant digits, we get a final speed of 4.27 meters per second. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zacks Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.